Everybody, this is called Thanksgiving Turkey of Compassion.
Hi, my name is Joseph. Remember the story of the talking donkey that saved the life of his master named Balaam? The donkey rode Balaam away from the invisible sword that was to cut off Balaam's head. Balaam did not see the sword, so he beat the donkey for going off the path away from the danger Balaam could not see. God allowed the donkey to talk to Balaam in order to explain. This story can be found in the book of Numbers chapter 22. Balaam was thought to be a good man because he refused to speak what God did not speak. Balaam got in trouble with God by telling the king how to trick the Israelites to giving them food offering to idol. Balaam acted against God, yet God the donkey to have mercy toward Balaam. God allowed the donkey to speak. Do you remember the scripture in Luke 19 verse 37 through 40? In this scripture, the unbelieving boss named Pharisees told Jesus to stop the people from praising him. Jesus told him that the rocks will cry out if he stopped them. The rocks will cry out. God allows all laws to be broken for his glory. Thanksgiving Turkey of Compassion is a skit about a fictitious Thanksgiving turkey that God gave the ability to speak in order to teach mercy and compassion. I believe that as this story unfolds, you will see the possibility that God can do all things. I pray that all will see and remember Ephesians 6 verse 10 through 20. We hope that all will keep on the whole armor of God. The story opens in a big farm yard. Many of the turkeys have been taken to slaughter with only a few left. The main turkey and two other turkeys are out in the yard scratching, gobbling, and walking about. They have not realized that they are next in line for the market shelf. The main turkey walks toward the audience and starts talking to the audience.
It's been 1 year, and everything is getting so big. Go, 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 go.
Slaughter man one comes into the yard room and chases down turkey one. Slaughter man one carries the turkey outside the room or behind the partition. The turkey screams and the axe hits the wood. Then you hear silence.
Where is my friend?
Maine turkey starts stinking. He crosses his arms and holds his chin as if he in a thinking position.
Where is my friend Mina? I wonder where is my friend Stephanie, Cristiano, and where is my friend Jack? I miss them so much. I haven't seen them since last Thanksgiving also. Go.
Slaughterman 2 comes in and chases down Turkey 2. Slaughterman 2 carries the turkey outside the room or behind the partition. The turkey screams and the axe hits the wood. Then you hear the silence. Slaughterman 1 comes in to get Maine Turkey. He chases Maine Turkey a little. Slaughterman starts puffing from being tired. Maine Turkey just stops and starts talking. Slaughterman 1 puffs from being tired.
Isaiah 41, 10 to 13 says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my gracious right hand."
What's going on?
It's a talking turkey.
OMG. ventriloquist?
Peter 5:7-6, cast all your anxieties on God and Jesus because he cares for you. Hebrews 13:6 says, keep your life free from love of money and be content with what you have, for he has said that I will never leave you nor forsake you. Philippians 4:6-7 says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Psalm 145:8-9. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and great in mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tenderness are over all his due, because his compassion fail not. They're new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Mark 6:34. And Jesus, when he came out, saw a deep multitude and was moved with compassion for them, because they were like sheep not having a shepherd. So he began to teach them many things. Luke 6:36, therefore, be merciful just as our Father also is merciful.
The angel of God appears, runs out, and settles this moment of compassion and mercy. God, through his angel, rewards the people for listening and knowing the words of God.
We thank you for being here with us this afternoon. We want to look at the volunteers. Everybody, look at the volunteers who came over to share with you. Give everybody a big hand of a round of applause. We want to give applaud the people who tried to do the work to do the skit. Give them an applaud also. We're getting ready to pray our final prayer, and at this point we'll let it be turned over to Captain Borrego.
Wonderful. We're going to pray to end this amazing time we had together. Thank you everybody for coming, and we hope you enjoyed your dinner with us here at the Salvation Army. Let's pray so that we can be dismissed from this wonderful event. At the conclusion of my prayer, please, if anybody is isn't parked in a parking spot, we need you to move, because people are coming out and your car is blocking the people who want to get out. Some of them are way in there, and your car, all of the cars need to be moved that are blocking other cars. All right, let's pray. Thank you, God, for this meal. Thank you, God, for today. And thank you for providing this day that you have made. Thank you for the volunteers, and thank you for everybody that made this day a wonderful day, a day that we're going to remember. Bless it. In your name we pray, Lord. And all God's people said, amen. All right, everybody. Have a great night, and thank you for coming.